Hey everyone, what is up? Welcome to or welcome back to the Lovely Wolf Den. I'm Nadia, and let's talk about music I found in the month of May. Alright, so I have to be honest, I was pretty worried about how this past month was gonna go, because for like half the month, I felt like I wasn't really finding anything that really grabbed my attention like the music from last month did. But as this month came to a close, I actually ended up being really, really happy and excited about my playlist, and it took me a while to actually choose what songs I was gonna talk about. I ended up with 5, which I think is the most that I've done in this series so far. So yeah, and I also have a mini list of honorable mentions at the end, so let's get started. Alright, so the first song that I'm going to talk about is the song 8 by IU featuring Suga from BTS, and he also produced the song. By the way, if I'm looking down, it's because like I have my notes on my phone. This is the first time that I wrote down all my thoughts beforehand so that I wasn't tripping over my words as much, so just a little disclaimer. This song came out on the 6th of this month. IU, quick little note about her, she's been in the K-pop industry since 2007, so she's a queen. And Suga, or Min Yoongi, is a member of BTS, one of my biases, if I may add. And so this was a really highly anticipated collab that was gonna come out. I thought he was just gonna produce it, but he also featured on it, so it just made it like that much more exciting. First of all, like going off of just the feeling I get when I listen to the song, it feels like I'm flying through the clouds, if that makes any sense. Like the feeling I get when I listen to it is it's like sunset, so it's like it's got that like nice like orangish hue, and then like I'm just like floating through the clouds. I don't even know, like that's just how I feel. And then a little fact on IU, she has this series called the Age series where she has released songs about like whatever age that she was at. So she has a song called 23, and it's about her struggling with whether she's ready to be an adult or like wanting to like hold on to childhood and stuff. And then her song Palette is about being 25 and feeling confident but still having like questions and doubts about yourself. And then this song is about being 28, and both her and Yoongi are 28, so. And it's about accepting your age and letting go of the past and ready to withstand and endure the future. A line that I really like in this is when Yoongi says, "The word forever is a sandcastle." Here are some tweets that I found on Twitter when the song came out that really explained like that line and why it's like, I don't know, kind of significant to me and stuff a lot better than I could. So this person said, "Forever is a sandcastle, sandcastle, sand that breaks apart at the slightest of touches, takes eternity to build and seconds to crumble. That's how meek and feeble of a concept forever is." And then someone piggybacked off of that and said, "Interesting bit about sand too, the more you try to hold it tight, the more you lose it. We shouldn't dwell much over the concept of eternity. Life, love, lost, goodbyes are not forever. There's no point in beating ourselves up over how fragile they are." And so, I don't know, it's just like lyrics like that that really get you like thinking and stuff, but on the surface they sound like so like sandcastles and stuff. So this song is pretty amazing. So moving on. Next song that I'm going to talk about is Monsters by All Time Low featuring Black Bear. This song came out with an album in April, like at the beginning of April, but I found it on one of the playlists that Spotify made for me, and I was really excited about it because honestly, I was just like really happy to be into an All Time Low song again. All Time Low has been around for a long time, and I was a big fan. I mean, I still am a big fan, but I used to listen to them a lot, like at my early high school years and stuff, and even younger since Camille would listen to them too. But the last album that I really loved from them was their 2015 Future Hearts album. And after that, I just felt like they kind of lost their way a bit. To me personally, at least, the sound was just like, I don't know, it wasn't something I was really vibing with. The album after, in 2017, Last Renegade, it just didn't hit the mark with me. When I listened to this song, however, I got the same feeling that I did when I listened to like Backseat Serenade, Reckless and the Brave, or Stella and stuff. And then Black Bear was featured. That really took me by surprise. And honestly, Black Bear always features in the places that I least expect it, and then it's always super great. So this song is like, from what I gather, is about being in like a toxic relationship, wondering why you keep running back to the person that constantly ruins your life. That concept and the way that it's executed was just chef's kiss. And I listened to the rest of the album, and well, like, at least I like this one song. Let's move on to the next one. So the next song that I'm going to talk about is Aquarius, Let the Sun Shine In by The Fifth Dimension. Let me tell you, I found this song off of the current Just Dance, and Camille and I didn't even dance to it. Like, I just immediately saw the title and I was like, I'm adding that to my library. And I went on, added it to my library, and then added it to this playlist because I was just like, I'm going to listen to this later and I'm going to love it. So given the fact that I am a raging Aquarius, I just automatically knew I was going to love it. After listening to it, I have to say this is the best Aquarius song I have heard yet. It's so upbeat, it's so lively, it just really gets me going. I love it so much. This particular recording of the song is from the year 2000, which happens to be the year that I was born. The song is actually from a musical that opened in 1968 called Hair. In this version, it's kind of a combination of two songs, so it's only Aquarius that was performed in the musical, and it was performed by Broadway singers Galtz McDermott and Ronnie Dyson, if I pronounce those wrong. I'm so sorry, but I gotta acknowledge them. My dad told me a bit about this musical, and honestly, I can't wait to dive like more into it and like listen to the rest of the soundtrack because it sounds amazing, and I can't help but assume that the rest of the songs are hits. My favorite line is literally the whole song. Just listen to this. When the moon is in the seventh house and Jupiter aligns with Mars, then peace will guide the planets and love will steer the stars. This is the dawning of the age of Aquarius. It's such an Aquarius song and I thrive while listening to it. So yeah, that's that on that. The next song is Rocket by girl group En Vogue. One night, Camille and I, we were like listening and watching music videos from like more Camille's childhood. She felt it like strange that I hadn't watched like old Lady Gaga music videos and stuff, so we were watching that. And then we were watching like other things. We ended up talking about how we feel like American girl groups don't really like do very well. I was just like, yeah, well, the only ones that I can think of are the Pussycat Dolls and the Spice Girls. And Camille was like, Nadia, the Spice Girls are European. And I was like, so that says a lot, I think, about American girl groups. So then Camille showed me En Vogue because she was like, I know that there like have been some, they just like don't get as much attention as they should. This particular song came out in 2018, but the group has been around since 1989. Y'all, let me tell you, this song has no business being that good. As soon as I started listening to it, I was so enchanted by it. Not only are the women in this group so stunning, but their vocals are amazing and the production in this song popped off. Like, I'm not even lying. I don't even, like, you can ask Camille, the way I was when we were listening to this song for the first time, I was just like feeling it and vibing to it instantly. Oh my gosh. And it's a love song. I was so excited to have a love song that I was happy about during this month because last month, like, every song that I talked about was depressing. So it's a nice change of pace. So yeah, in conclusion, I love me some girl groups and y'all need to listen to this song. All right, so the last thing that I'm gonna talk about is not just one song, but a mixtape as a whole, because there's absolutely no way I can choose just one thing to talk about. I have to talk about this whole mixtape in its entirety. D2 by August D, aka Minyoongi, aka Suga of BTS. All right, so first of all, why does this dude have three names? Well, let me tell you. Minyoongi's stage name for BTS is Suga, and then August D is another persona that he has. And August D is Suga spelled backwards plus DT, which stands for Daegu Town, which is like his city, like where he grew up in and stuff. So the difference between Suga and August D is, and I'm referencing this from his interview in Time Magazine, the difference is that there is a lot more that I can openly express and that I can show a more raw side to myself with August D. What's similar is that both sing of dreams and hope. The first August D mixtape that came out in 2016 focused more on Yoongi's past and like his struggles with mental health and stuff. A very powerful mixtape, if I do say so. Whereas this time he's talking about himself in the present. This mixtape is definitely a lot different from his first in the sense that like I can only imagine how much has changed, because if you look at the differences as far as BTS goes from like 2016 and now. In 2016, they weren't nearly as big as they were now, and currently they're like the biggest artists in the world. So I can only imagine how much of an impact that had on him as like an artist and stuff and as a person. He said himself that like he listened to his first mixtape a lot and he feels like he upgraded so much, and the way he rapped then is a lot different from how he would rap now. There is honestly so much I can dissect like with this album. I mean, the single Dechita alone like has so much to talk about. I could probably make a whole video on this mixtape, but really like this mixtape is so special to me. I wasn't into K-pop in 2016, so I obviously wasn't there for the release of his first mixtape. So the fact that I'm here now and I'm able to like resonate so much with what he's saying makes it really special to me, like, and especially on top of the fact that he's one of my biases. I adore his work ethic and the way he is so eloquent with his words. It just makes me really happy and proud to call myself his fan. And I love all of these songs so fiercely and so differently, but I think the song that probably resonates with me the most is his song People. Since I already talked a lot, I won't go too much into it, but like basically upon the first listen of that song, I was immediately like, I already know that this is gonna be like my favorite song. And then when I read the lyrics, it was just even more like, wow. The way he speaks is already like thoughtful, I guess. So like when he raps and like in his music, you can just feel so much emotion and like so much thought was put into like everything that he's saying. And it's just so fantastic. So I totally recommend this mixtape. And yeah, that's all I'm gonna say about that. Before I end this video, I wanna give a quick shout out to honorable mentions that I wanted to talk about. But if I did, then this video would be so much longer than it probably already is. Be Kind by Marshmallow and Halsey, Dreams by The Cranberries, Lights On by Sid B, Soyo by Bomba Estéreo, Wildflower by 5 Seconds of Summer, What It Is by Kyle, Fairy of Shampoo by Tomorrow by Together, and Peonia by Busters. I hope that y'all enjoyed another video. I can't believe that like this is already what my third music of the month video. I've been really enjoying it so far and I hope y'all have been too. With that, thank you so much for watching another lovely video. As always, please make sure to like and subscribe if you have not already. Comment down below anything you'd like to see any of the Lovelywolfe creators do, and if you'd like more content from us, join our Patreon. The link will be in the description down below. Thank you so much for watching. Catch y'all later.